Hello, in this video I shall be giving the analysis of the topic Need for a Federal Coalition to Preserve the Idea of Plural India. India is a pluralistic state. It is majorly a pluralistic country. We need to have federal coalition or federal alliance working at the center to preserve this pluralistic idea of India. So not giving a majority, absolute majority to a single party, but there has to be a federal alliance in the center. We shall analyze about this. There is a recent statement from the health member of NITI Aayog, and even to which states agreed, that is, the reason for poor vaccination drive in India is due to lack of centralization in India, and because of that there is poor management of this vaccination drive. This is what he says in a short way, and here he reiterates on lack of centralization in vaccination drive. This might hold true for vaccination drive, but in India today we see growing centralization regarding every aspect. But why not into vaccination drive, we do not know. But the centralization is actually growing in India. So as contrary to this statement, we shall see the growing centralization in India and how that is affecting the pluralism in India or pluralistic idea of India. So growing centralization, we can see it in center governing the state subjects. Like its hand is mostly felt in health, education and agriculture, where states have to spend 85% on infrastructure of health and 82% on infrastructure of education. The policies are majorly framed by center. So that is what is happening. And even some slogans like one nation, one tax, one market, one nation, all of these we are seeing in this decade or from the past 8 years. So these slogans give the idea of having more centralized work of the public policy and all. So this is also showing that there is growing centralization and less importance is given to state governments and states' play, where democratic leaders are elected. And this might be the reason behind growing centralization, that center must be thinking to provide India with strength, like with strong nation state idea. But this is over exploited by center getting into every aspect of state related topics. And we shall see now the union encroachment into state related things. This is a problem from post-independent India. It's not a recent problem, but now it is exaggerated and now it's growing too high or amplified. And through dismissing these democratically elected leaders' policies, the center would always give more power to governor to make its policies work in a state. So this is one weapon through which it encroaches into state. For example, education, which used to be a topic under state list, the center made it into a concurrent list topic so that it can have its play in governing the whole educational policies of all states. And even these days we are seeing huge resource allocations to states and welfare interventions to different states by the center, so which is giving a dynamic role to center. We shall see this also in GST case. Goods and services tax, a tax that has come replacing indirect tax system in India. Indirect taxes majorly they go to states previously, but now due to GST, the whole taxation that states used to get, now it is going to center now. So because of this, the states are getting less revenue, so the generation of revenue is very less to the states, but they are to incur more expenditure. So this is one deficit that states are facing due to GST. And even today we see centrally sponsored schemes, this concept getting very high, in which the center is coming into different states to make its schemes, to make its projects work. So this is some union encroachment or center's encroachment into state things. And for even capital, for money, the states have to depend on center today mostly, which is not the case some years back. So because of this economic power totally vested with the central government, the states have to have some capital relation with strong foundation with the center. And the states, for this reason, this is a political game that states have to politically align with the central party. Those state governments which are politically aligning to central party, they are going to get good allocations from the center. So that is even felt in vaccination drive, where we can see a differential pricing of vaccines for different states. For example, there is also this decline of businesses in South India ever since the present government has come up in center, which is very evident that this political aligning with the central party is important for entrepreneurs of a state. There is also no RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. So the central government has not opted for RCEP, So this would protect big businesses in India to avoid competition globally. So this, in this way, the center is oriented towards some big businesses, and also it is going to give some immunity to some businesses which are very close to the center. So this friendship or this close relation with the center will fetch you good things in business field. So this is what the present government is running on. And there are no state level barriers. This is bad to some small regional entrepreneurs. So directly there are no, if there are no state level barriers, any entrepreneur can directly have a link with the center and grow his entrepreneurship and even make huge policy decisions of the center, like not entering into RCEP and all. But these small regional entrepreneurs, they depend mostly on state, which is not given a major importance in entrepreneurship because of the center. And also there are some rent thick sectors like mining, real estate and all, which would fetch good amount to the state. But now even center is seeking rent from these sectors. And there are also other discrepancies in electoral funding to the center. So as it is rent seeking towards these mining sector and all, it would have more fund, the central government. Undoubtedly, it would use it for electoral purposes. And it is also giving corruption charges based on some central agencies on the governments which are not aligning towards that particular party in center. So these are some state capital relations to the center that state has to depend for its money on center, mostly, which is a growing issue today in India. The next thing is institutional transgression or violating the institutions for its use. So with this legislative or executive aggression, this center is imposing some problems or imposing some guidelines on states that are weakening the state policies. For example, it is using some agencies like Income Tax Department, Enforcement Directorate, National Investigation Agency and all. And even it is having its hand in the appointments of vice chancellors of some universities, and these universities are totally funded and they are run by the government of state. So when they are funded and run by state governments, there has to be no say by the center, but they are involving the appointments of their vice chancellors. So they are using this kind of institutional transgressions. And even direct benefits transfer is one institution. It is bypassing state government and directly giving money to the state people. They are accepting money, and this is nowhere related to the state government. And even some meetings are bypassing state government heads, like some meetings with the state secretaries and district collectors by the central ministers or by the prime minister, by bypassing this concept of state government and elected representatives. For example, the Ministry of Education recently held a meeting with state educational secretaries about national education policy. So this is bypassing the state government. So in this way, they are using some institutional violations, and even sudden national lockdown is announced without consulting the states, for which some states like Rajasthan have seen this migration of laborers crisis. And even vaccine has got different prices. So differential prices of vaccine is there in India right now based on different criteria for different states. And also, how would this impact socio-cultural fabric of India? India is made up of regional diversity, especially based on culture. So Indian federalism is totally based on legal and constitutional backups, and this cannot be homogenized. One cannot homogenize India because we have a huge diversity here, diversity in culture, religion, social, society and all. But the center is trying to bring everybody under one pan-India concept today. But every state doesn't fit well into that. For example, Tamil Nadu, which is an example of anti-Vedic tradition, it cannot have a Hindu past. So, but bringing it under one homogenized society, you cannot alter the past of Tamil Nadu. And even in West Bengal, they are trying to link Sonar Bangla with Hindu past. So making these Muslim West Bengal people or Christian West Bengal people less Bengalis. So you cannot make like that. And even Dravidians are attacked by calling them as British creation. And so all these things are diversified and very diverse. You cannot homogenize India. So, but the central government is right now going with homogenization of concepts. The drawbacks that we have in constitution are residuary powers of center and concurrent list. And these are biased towards center, and this is giving overruling powers to the center. But we need to protect the pluralism in India. A way forward to it is we need to restore the powers to state, respect constitution, federalism, and governance must be free of political coalition. Finally, we need to respect diversities of India. So this is the topic about federal coalition to preserve rural India, and thank you.